The tallest skyscrapers in the world stand proudly, symbols of human audacity and technological mastery. But what happens when a building in London accidentally turns its facade into a solar weapon capable of melting cars in the middle of the day? Or when a team of engineers discovers that one of Manhattan's most prestigious buildings might collapse with the next gust of wind? Today, we explore five architectural disasters that shook the world of construction. These errors, often hidden for years, reveal the fine line between technological marvels and monumental failures. They've also swallowed up fortunes along the way. The Walkie-Talkie Building, London. In the heart of London stands a skyscraper that managed to become both the most mocked building in Britain and an unintended threat to its surroundings. The Walkie-Talkie. It was sold for a record-breaking $1.7 billion to a Hong Kong company, but its fame doesn't stem from its astronomical price tag. Rather, it's due to the disaster caused by its design. Architect Raphael Vignoli created the building with a slightly concave glass facade. While this may have seemed like an innocent design choice, it turned into a catastrophe when the building opened in 2014. The curved surface acted as a giant parabolic mirror, concentrating the sun's rays onto a single point on the street. The heat was so intense that temperatures reached 6 times higher than normal. Consequences were quickly felt. Car parts melted, shop windows deformed, and even the sidewalk cracked under the intense heat. The most publicized incident occurred when a journalist managed to fry an egg on the street using only the heat reflected from the building. This stunt went viral, turning the Walkie-Talkie into a frying skyscraper. Even more embarrassing for Vignoli, this wasn't the first time he had encountered this issue. His Vidara Hotel in Las Vegas had caused a similar problem, nicknamed the Death Ray by pool guests. Although Vignoli had initially planned to add sunshades to prevent this problem in London, they were removed for aesthetic reasons. The final solution cost $14 million, installing a massive permanent sunshade, making this architectural mistake one of the most expensive lessons in basic physics in modern construction history. Stuttgart 21, Germany. In the heart of Germany, the Stuttgart 21 project embodies the overambition of an engineering endeavor that defied all logic. The goal was simple: to transform a century-old terminus station into a modern transit hub by rotating it 90 degrees. This rotation would allow trains to continue without reversing, fitting into a high-speed line stretching from Paris to Bratislava over 1,500 kilometers. What was meant to be a masterpiece of engineering, costing 6.5 billion euros, turned into a logistical nightmare. The project, initially set for completion in 2019, is now expected to finish in 2025, and even that date remains uncertain. The first major challenge lay underground, where engineers faced an invisible but formidable opponent, a particular type of soil that expands when in contact with water. This geological characteristic threatened the stability of the 60 kilometers of tunnels needed to connect the new station to the existing network. Each advancement in digging came with the risk of gradual deformation of the tunnels, requiring costly and continuous repairs. But nature had more surprises in store. In 2017, the project was halted after a colony of protected lizards was discovered along the planned route. Their relocation became an unexpectedly complex operation. With costs reaching $10,000 per reptile, this ecological twist added $18 million to the final bill. Current estimates suggest the total cost could reach $12 billion, more than double the original budget. These skyrocketing expenses have made Stuttgart 21 a monument to the unpredictability of large infrastructure projects, where each layer of soil hides a new challenge, and even the smallest creatures can have a massive impact on the grandest engineering plans. Citigroup Center, New York City. In the heart of Manhattan stands the Citigroup Center, a 280-meter colossus with a terrifying secret hidden in its history. Its defining feature? An elevated base resting on 4 massive 34-meter pillars. This was a groundbreaking architectural feat, but it could have turned into an unprecedented disaster. The story took a chilling turn in 1978 when a Princeton civil engineering student, Diane Hartley, raised a question that sent shivers down the spines of engineers. She suggested that the wind resistance calculations for the building might be incomplete. Her hunch would prove prophetic. The initial studies had only considered wind hitting the building's facades perpendicularly. No one had accounted for the impact of diagonal winds hitting the building's corners. A deeper analysis revealed a terrifying truth. The tower could collapse in a storm that occurs once every 55 years. Even worse, if the mass damper failed, a gust of wind that occurred once every 16 years could trigger the disaster. The collapse wouldn't be self-contained. The tower could fall onto neighboring skyscrapers, potentially causing the biggest architectural catastrophe in New York City's history. Urgency reached its peak when Hurricane Ella was projected to hit the city. Only a handful of people, including the mayor of New York, were informed in order to prevent panic. Engineers worked through the night for 3 months, welding 5-centimeter-thick steel plates onto the joints to reinforce the structure. By a twist of fate, Hurricane Ella changed course and spared the city. Repairs were completed by October 1978, and the secret was kept for 17 years. It wasn't until 1995, during an informal conversation, that William Lemessurier, the chief engineer, revealed this unbelievable story, demonstrating how Manhattan's fate rested on the insight of one student and the tireless work of a team of engineers. Jeddah Tower, Saudi Arabia. The Jeddah Tower was meant to be the first skyscraper to surpass the 1 kilometer mark, eclipsing its rival, the Burj Khalifa, with 167 floors and becoming the ultimate symbol of Middle Eastern architectural audacity. Launched in 2013 with an initial budget of $1.5 billion, the tower was supposed to be the centerpiece of a new 5.3 square kilometer economic district, embodying Saudi Arabia's ambition to diversify its economy beyond oil. However, in 2018, the project was abruptly halted. The cranes, once symbols of rapid progress, became motionless sentinels on a ghost construction site. The official reason for the stoppage was technical difficulties, but the reality was far more complex, tied to the deep political turbulence of the region. In the midst of a massive anti-corruption purge in Saudi Arabia, key figures of the project, including investor Prince Al-Waleed bin Talal and the head of the Saudi bin Laden Group, were arrested. This political storm turned the construction site into collateral damage in the broader geopolitical upheaval. Technical challenges also proved more complex than expected, as constructing such a tall structure requires concrete capable of withstanding extreme pressures while being pumped to dizzying heights. The harsh desert winds and extreme temperatures made each construction step more difficult, forcing engineers to constantly rethink their methods. Today, the tower stands at just 400 meters, less than half its planned final height. The additional costs from the construction halt have never been officially disclosed, but experts estimate they far exceed the original budget, with each day of delay adding maintenance costs and causing wear to existing structures exposed to the elements. The Jeddah Tower has become a symbol of excessive ambition, clashing with the realities of both the terrain and regional politics, reminding us that even the most ambitious projects can be undone by forces far beyond engineering. Berlin, Brandenburg International Airport, Germany. The Berlin-Brandenburg International Airport was meant to be the showcase of German technological efficiency. Instead, it became the perfect example of what happens when everything that can go wrong does. Originally slated to open in 2011, the airport didn't welcome its first flight until 2020. After 9 years of delays and a fourfold increase in the initial budget. The project became a cascade of Kafka-esque technical errors. Engineers found 67 kilometers of incorrectly installed cables, 4,000 misnumbered doors, and a fire detection system so complicated that it simply didn't work. Even more absurdly, the ordered escalators were a few steps too short. The flight information screens were obsolete before they could even be used. The most surreal discovery came when it was revealed that 4,000 smoke detectors, instead of being connected to a central system, were operating autonomously. To address this, the management considered hiring 800 people whose sole job would have been to patrol the airport 24/7 with walkie-talkies to report any smoke. The final blow came when the cost ballooned from 2.7 billion euros to 7.3 billion euros. But the real financial impact is still being felt, even after opening. The airport loses around 1 million euros a day in operating costs, a financial sinkhole that could take decades to recover from. From the accidental solar mirror in London to the unstable tunnels of Stuttgart. These monumental mistakes teach us that even the best planned projects can fail. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you later.